well, it's not out yet, so looks like it. We must wait until Operation Sirens gets released. How about we do this stupid cat in the meantime? And with that, I welcome everyone to the new guide, this time featuring the HMS Cheshire, and to make it special I even decided to wear a Santa hat myself, so that everything would be Christmas-like, since it is already so close around the corner. But enough talking about Christmas for now, because this is a stupid cat guide, so let's focus on that. The HMS Cheshire was supposed to be a heavy cruiser with big scary 234mm guns, but since we have the Cheshire as a PR ship, and know already what happened, she was never built. The only redeeming feature was her blueprint, and that was pretty much it. The plan to build such a ship was cancelled, since World War II came across, and we know what happened there. But before we continue, let's welcome our sponsor of today's giveaway, me. Yeah, we don't have a real sponsor today, but for that we got something for you. Namely a giveaway where you can win some nice rewards like Discord Nitro, or Discord Nitro again. Yeah, don't blame me, do I look like I have money or something? But you probably wonder how you can win. Well, pretty simple, just get good. But seriously now, all you need to do is post a comment with the hashtag PadoruPadoru, and you will enter the giveaway. But back to the video now. You can get the HMS Cheshire by selling your soul to Yosta, or also better known as playing the games for 30 hours straight, because Cheshire is a PR ship, which means that it is pretty grindy to get her, at least for people that also play other games except as a lane. So after you spend your 30 hours or more, you will need to spend even more time to level her up, since you need blueprints, and these blueprints you can only get by researching projects. So it is an infinite cycle of suffering, but in the end you will get a really nice and annoying cat, so depends if you like it or not. Thankfully, I didn't need to grind, since a viewer of mine gave me some gameplay for this video. So let's first talk about her firepower. This stupid cat somehow managed to get under the top 10 with her firepower. I don't know how, but somehow it worked out for her. Has probably something to do with the fact that she was supposed to have 234mm guns, but because of that fact she also got one of the slowest reloading stats in the game for a heavy cruiser. Only beaten by Drake. Yeah, doesn't look great for now. But we all know that having bad reload doesn't mean instantly bad ship. Next on we would have the survivability, and this is where things get interesting. Cheshire has a pretty solid amount of hit points at around 4600 HP, and she also has in some way good evasion at 33 points. This is not right out special, but what is the fact that Cheshire has medium armor, and this on its own is something really rare, since most of the British cruiser are made out of paper. At the moment someone sneezes in their direction, they instantly die. So she can actually take a punch. At least the British had the intention of building a cruiser with some armor. It's not like it would matter. Which brings us to our next stat, namely her torpedoes. The torps on Cheshire, to say it nice, aren't the best, especially for a PR ship. It even gets surpassed by a German ship, which is unacceptable, but at least the Germans are good. And one thing this time. Her torpedoes are mostly good for taking down low HP enemies. Because of her 155% efficiency, you can also give somebody a nice hit in PvP. And now lastly, her anti-air. This is the point where I got actually surprised, because she has actually AA. I didn't expect that. Cheshire has the best anti-air among all heavy cruiser. Nothing comes even close to her. With that AA stat you could easily even beat some light cruisers, since she also has 165% of efficiency on her anti-air gun. Well, this were all her stats, but we don't stop here, since next on the list we have her perks, which make this stupid cat even more unique. Cheshire has a whopping amount of 4 perks, which is unique for normal ships, but pretty standard for PR ships. Her first perk is Grin and Fire. You take 15% less damage, since this ship isn't tanky enough. In addition to that, you have a 100% chance to fire a special barrage 12 seconds after the battle started, which sends pause at the enemy. I really like the idea behind this skills, especially the flying pause, to remind you that she is an annoying cat. Next on is Bounce Right Back. I just wonder why they chose that kind of name for a skill. But whatever, your first torpedo launch has an decreased loading time of 70%. To that, every time you take damage, you've got a 15% chance to increase the firepower, evasion and anti-air of this ship by 5%. Till the battle ends, this can be stacked up to 3 times. Yeah, this really strong on its own. The longer the battles last, the more damage Cheshire will deal. She be sure to keep that in mind. For the third perk, we would have Siren Killer. Nobody expected that, come on. It increases damage against sirens by 15%. What else can I say? And lastly, her all-out assault skill, which sends some pause in the general direction of your enemies. It has a pretty good damage output. So with that, let's jump right into her equipment. As for the main battery gun, I use the Twin 234mm prototype gun. This is pretty much one of the best choices for her main gun. If you go purely for damage output, I cannot say much to the triple 234mm gun yet, since I don't own it myself yet. If you don't have it yet, go with the triple 203mm prototype, which is pretty much the best choice if you are poor. And for the real people that have no equipment, go for the twin 203mm one. But I doubt you will be this poor if you have the Cheshire at this moment. For the torpedoes, you go with the German quadruple homing torpedo mount, since the damage on this torps isn't the best, and you definitely want all of them to hit. And now her anti-air gun. For that, you want to spend the best equipment you have, so either you take the new sextuple 40mm Bofors gun with the best DPS in the game, or if you don't have it yet, go with the twin 113mm one, for the bigger and more consistent range. Lastly, her auxiliary equipment. You can build the Cheshire like most ships for tanking, but since Cheshire has pretty strong AA, you can enhance it even more. So for the first slot, you take definitely an improved hydraulic rudder for the extra evasion. As for the second slot, you can either take an high performance AA radar to enhance your anti-air even more, or if you have no interest in dealing with planes, you take an repair toolkit to get your typical cruiser build. Well, with that, we covered pretty much Cheshire. Cheshire is for sure a ship worth getting. And even if you don't like her, you still got yourself a nice and annoying cat with a family friendly skin. So before I go, don't forget to like and subscribe. And don't miss out on the giveaway. Just post a comment with the hashtag PadoruPadoru and you entered. Until next time, your Peppa Gnick.